Right, I'm just starting a live. Let's see who's going to join us. Listen to some music. It's what's called God. Hometown Heroes. Mr. Carmack. How's everyone doing? Thank you very much for joining in. Much love. Let's breathe. Savor the taste of the life force. How's everyone doing? Much love. Thank you very much for joining in. All right, we've got a few people joined us. Coolio. Hope everyone's doing well. Quite a few new faces. Well, I haven't done a live for a little while, so it's been a while since I've done live. I've been typically doing one probably about once a week, if that. Hey, Lucid Aferity, how's it going? Good afternoon. One Mohammed, feel big love. It's all about love here, man. That's why I started this page. Back in the day, well, 2 years now. 2 years ago, I started this page. And yeah, it's grown from strength to strength. It's been helping a lot of people all around the world. Just sharing information about my journey. It's basically the best way to learn, isn't it? Through life itself and the journeys we go through. Mustn't grumble, hoping to learn some things on your lives. How are you? I'm very good, thank you very much. Obviously working always on my life force energy, the chi flow, just always consistently working on my own energy. I've often said, like, sometimes it takes some pain or suffering to give you a bit of a wake-up call, right? That's okay. That's normal, man, right? It's okay to make mistakes. It's okay to do shit wrong. That's actually the best way to fucking learn, okay? I'm, like, someone that's been through a lot but come through on the other side. So whether it's been loss of a loved one, my brother, my father, addictions, cocaine addictions, all that shit, right? Alcohol, I gave up all that shit, smoking. But you know, it's not like I ain't done it, okay? So, you know, rather have the experience of being through something and then overcoming it rather than, and that's really the best people to learn from, someone that's actually been through the experiences and still going through the journey, right? Like, healing doesn't stop. And this is what I always try to explain people. You know, healing over trauma, losing loved ones, depression, right? I've been labeled with a depressive disorder, emotionally unstable personality disorder, right? These are labels that were given to me. So, but, you know, the way I saw it is as a reason to do something about it, okay? I've got physical injuries, as many of you guys know, right? Some of you guys might not know, but I developed a slip disc in my spine. Injury happened more than likely a few years ago, okay? Quite a long time ago from doing heavy squats and deadlifts. I used to go quite heavy on squats and deadlifts, and obviously many of you guys now have been into martial arts, karate, Wing Chun, Kung Fu, boxing, Krav Maga. But I had to sort of change my lifestyle to reflect a new version of me, in a sense, okay? And, you know, awakening sort of takes you through that journey where a lot has to change around you, the people around you, your environment, everything. Because the way the divine works, when you're going through a spiritual awakening, a lot of things change. And sometimes, okay, and I've learned to believe that these obstacles, these things that we call problems, okay, it might be mental health issues, physical health issues, right? They are there to challenge us, to help us grow, okay? Because without any of the struggles and the obstacles I've had in life, without them, I would be fucking weak, right? So it's the struggles that make you stronger, if everything is always okay, there's nothing to test you to grow. It's like you want to grow a muscle. You can't grow a muscle without putting it under some stress, right? So evolution is going to come with some stress. So when you are growing mentally, physically, or spiritually, there's going to be some stress to induce the growth, okay? Even a Kundalini awakening, okay? Kundalini awakening, the practice itself, is by causing stress in a way here in this area, right? You know, in Qigong, we work with the lower Dan Tian, and obviously with the chakra systems, with the KAMOTiON Qigong system that I teach. You know, we work with a combination of the energetic centers and the chakras as well. But, you know, there's a whole process to everything, right? There's a journey, but the growth, development journey in any shape or form doesn't ever come without some obstacles, right? I mean, without the obstacles, there's no real growth, because when the obstacles come, whatever it might be, okay, challenges come. With awakening, many people experience, see and hear things that they've never seen or heard before. Okay, it doesn't make sense to anyone else. Okay, and a lot of the time, as I've said before, many people are labeled as psychotic, or they've had a psychotic episode, so I've put a medication, so it suppresses them, suppresses these things. Okay, and actually, I can understand, okay, the awakening and what you experience can be unsettling for many, especially if you're unprepared, okay? But this is exactly what awakening does. It makes you suffer because you're unprepared so that you can get prepared. So there's always something to work on. So, you know, after, for example, a Kundalini awakening, you know, you've opened 72,000 nadis across your whole body. You've activated your light body. You've gone out of body, right? You've experienced your celestial self. Now you've got to come back to this reality. I've often said ascension, a lot of people speak about ascending, not a lot of people speak about descending. Descending is even fucking harder, okay? Because once you've ascended, what you knew about you and everything that you ever knew about existence is blown out the window. So you've got to then come back to this reality somehow and integrate the new you, okay, which isn't a physical you, right? Your celestial self, your higher self, the immortal self, okay? Because really that's what's controlling this avatar, but you lose connection with it, okay? And the shadow builds through repression, repressing. Placing limitations through doubts, fears. This is all fed to you. Okay, a lot of it's fed to you. You learn what to fear and how to fear. You learn it. You practice it. You practice it enough. Like anything. You practice anything enough, it becomes an unconscious habit. So, the way we behave, what we do, the way we act, everything. We've rehearsed it. Okay, but your unconscious mind plays it out automatically because it's been rehearsed so often. Okay, it's just like talking, just like walking, right? The way you be is the same thing. You rehearse it. You rehearse how to walk, how to talk. You rehearse everything. It's all mental programs. Now, beyond the mental programs, 4D, right? Energetic. Just rhythm, vibration, energy. Okay, you've got to see everything from an energetic perspective. Just energy. Okay, that's what Qigong is all about. KAMOTiON Qigong, what I teach. It's all about shifting from 3D perspective to the 4D energetic rhythm, vibration, connecting with that. Opening your senses just to rhythm, vibration, energy. Okay? Let go of all the labels. Let go of all everything else. Just understand yin-yang, duality. Just understand there's the opposite. The good and the bad. The light and the dark. Polarize both. You've got a dark side and a light side. Okay? Sometimes you got to go through the dark to figure out what you want to keep, right? Because you got to, the only real way to learn about yourself is through life. I don't care what anybody says. Okay, I'm 45 years old now. I know 10 years from now, I'm going to know more. I'm going to keep learning. Okay, never a full cup, because as long as once you, you know, keep emptying that cup, there's always more, okay? There's always more, right? It's infinite. It's eternal, okay? Abundance, right? Abundance is eternal. It's infinite. You are limitless. Consciousness is limitless. So how far you can take your consciousness and your evolution is limitless, as long as you don't keep putting limits on it. Okay, so we are the ones that place limits on ourselves. I still put limits on myself. I have to consistently keep fighting my own limitations, my doubts and fears. Okay, this never stops. Okay, you just get better with practice. But it's better to practice overcoming doubt, fear, and limitations rather than practicing living in doubt, fear, with limitations. So this takes practice every day, like daily practice. From the moment you wake up to the moment you go to sleep. Being above the waking, sleeping, dreaming states. That's what pure consciousness is. It's above all states. Transcended state. You got to live from that state. That's why once you've ascended and then you got to integrate, it can be quite hard, because an ascended state to live with requires balance. Okay? You can't be too... Okay, because your spiritual body, your infinite self, your higher self, there's no limitations, right? But here, sometimes just to fit in, we've got to place limitations. For example, I have to bring my energy down a lot, around a lot of people. Okay, because my energy quite naturally can be very high. So I practice a lot bringing my energy down. So energy mastery, right? It's not just about having energy. Okay, because when you've got like too much energy at the wrong time can be a bad thing, okay? But not enough energy at the right time is also a bad thing. So you've got to balance. It's always about balance, right? Like, you know, you've got to be able to bring your energy down too, okay? Like with Kundalini awakening, there's a lot of fire energy. The fire energy is the one that most people struggle with, because a lot of the one-to-one work that I do, when the people that join my group classes and my Zoom classes that I do every week, most of them have been through a Kundalini awakening. So they experience these symptoms, okay? There's symptoms that come along with awakening, okay? And you have access to more information. So you, in a sense, you've got to learn how to get out of the mind. This is what Qigong is great for, what I teach, the KAMOTiON Qigong system. Getting out of the head, getting into the body consciousness, getting into the energetic body, okay? Just feeling energy, okay? Not identifying with thoughts, emotions, feelings, not getting caught up with anything there. With the mental constructs, okay? As soon as you do that, you lose yourself, okay? So, got to get beyond that. Thoughts, feelings, emotions, all energy, okay? So, you know, energy is running throughout your whole body. It's all around you here as well, okay? Everything is energy. We just got to learn to connect with it, learn to unify with it, learn to balance our own energies, because we have feminine and masculine energies, right? So masculine energy is like that fire energy, right? The feminine energy is more like a water, sort of flowing, gentle energy. It's a passive energy, whereas a fire energy is an expressive yang energy. So the yin and the yang. So Qigong is all about balancing these energies, okay? Got to have both, okay? Because you don't want to just be in yin. You don't want to just be in yang, okay? Spend too much time in yin, it's going to become uncomfortable. Spend too much time in yang, it's going to become uncomfortable. Okay, yin is like a relaxed, peaceful, blissful state. Okay, you want to relax. Okay, you want to let go. Okay, relaxing is important. So in the Taoist philosophy, what I teach, okay, the Taoist way is to do nothing, then do everything. So when you do nothing, like completely let go, be embraced by the essence of all that is. Connect, just witness, observe the peace, the beauty, the serenity. Like connect with nature, especially a lot. That's what I tend to do when I'm not doing stuff and I'm not busy, like with work stuff. Or with clients, I spend time in nature, in my garden, walking in the countryside, as much as I possibly can. Just remind myself what I am, okay? Nature, okay? I am nature, meaning that there's a natural, effortless flow to all nature, okay? So human beings included, animals, plants, trees, everything, right? So everything has a natural flow to it. That's what we call the Tao, the way. So getting in flow with that is what I teach with in my classes. Get into that wu wei state, that flow state, living in that flow state, so that Zen state, getting into it. The Wu Wei state is the non-doing state. Okay, getting shit done without trying. Okay, so that's the flow state. Athletes get into it. We practice getting into it with Qigong. Okay, you get into it when you're trading stock markets. You get into it when you're playing a football game. You get into it when you're dancing. You get into it when you're talking like this. Okay, so the flow state is used everywhere. Okay, so it's a high performance state of mind. So we want to access that whenever we want. Water, female, fire, male. Yes, that's correct. So yin yang energies is what it's all about. Okay, male, female. We all have both. Okay, so there's a soft and hard energies. So really, as a human being, you only need two states of mind. Two. Be at peace and be energized. You either want to be at peace, that's what you want when you do nothing. And the other one is be energized so you can get shit done. That's all I need as a human being. I either need to do nothing, chill out, and when I want to chill out, I want to fucking really chill out. Right? And when I want to get shit done, I want to really get shit done. So what I need to do as a human being is just focus on working on being in the best, most peaceful, relaxed yin state possible and practicing getting into that. So this is done through practice. You practice getting into these states, right? Through Qigong. And you also want to get into the high energy productive state. So in terms of brainwave frequencies, your brainwaves change too, right? So your normal waking state for a human being, what I would call the zombie state, which is a normal waking state, just normal, I go into it, everybody does, when you're just not really, just normal, like when you're having a conversation with normal people, just being sort of around normal people, right? Okay, and just fitting in, okay, you're going to be beta, waking state. Now, above that, we've got gamma, and below that, we've got others, right? Alpha, brainwave frequency is a relaxed. So you're here, but you're relaxed. Slower, it's slightly slower than beta brainwave frequencies. Okay, so alpha brainwave frequencies, 8 to 14 cycles per second. Beta brainwave frequencies, like 15 to 21, 22 cycles per second. And theta is 4 to 8 cycles per second. So theta is a trance-like. So if you meditate for a long time, typically you will have to meditate for about 20, 30 minutes to get into a trance-like state. Sometimes a bit sooner if you're practicing longer. But trance-like meditation state will be theta brainwave frequency. So you're not asleep, but you're tapped into the unconscious mind. So as a neuro-linguistic programming therapist and a timeline therapist, I practice getting clients into the theta brainwave state so we have more access to the unconscious mind. So hypnotherapists do the same as well. So you can induce the theta trance-like state too, okay? So you can induce it through meditation practices, Qigong practices. You can induce it through hypnotherapy, binaural beats, isochronic technologies, and things like that. So these are audio technologies. So there's lots of ways to induce brainwave frequencies, but one of the easiest ways is just breathe. Okay, you breathe slower. Because everything is rhythm and vibration. You can control your rhythm and vibration just by consciously taking control of your rhythm of your breath. Okay, so now your breath is normally unconscious. Okay, but so are your thoughts. Most of your thoughts are unconscious. You're not using conscious thinking most of the time. Conscious thinking is when you're making choices. Okay, let me choose this from the menu. Okay, I want to go here. That's conscious choices. The rest of it is unconscious thoughts. Okay, they're unconscious, meaning you don't consciously choose them, they just exist. So very difficult to change those directly because there's millions of them. Your mind processes 4.3 million bits of information per second on an unconscious level. So you can't change that directly. So you have to work what's behind that. What's powering this unconscious mind? It's the energy. Okay? So if you have less energy and you lower your energy and level of vibration, you reduce the thinking, the level of thinking, the amount of thoughts being brought about. Okay, so you know, if you and also the way you feel is state of mind. 55% of it is down to physiology, so how you hold your body. Okay, that's why when you look at someone depressed or sad, they look very different to someone that's not depressed or sad. Okay, so if I'm depressed or sad, I'm gonna have my head down, shoulders down. I'm gonna have a depressed physiology. Just breathing properly and holding your body properly, you're much less likely to fall in that state. Now, unconsciously, you'll fall in the state and your body will take that form. So you take the form of how you feel. So always pay attention to how your body is. You know, keep your head up, breathing deep. Whenever you feel depressed or sad, your breath is going to go shallow. Okay, so take some deep breaths. Change your physiology. Go for a walk. That's why exercising can break the low mood state quite quickly. Just by going for a walk, go for a run, go to the gym. Okay, that's why a lot of people actually do work out, okay, for mental health. They're not necessarily doing it for physical. Okay, physical health is like a bonus. Like a lot of the time I've worked out, really, not really for physical. It's been more for my psychology. Just keep a, it makes me feel good, right? So my mind just doesn't feel right if I don't move, okay? Some people are just like that, okay? I know the difference if I'm moving, because it makes sense. From a Qigong perspective, the Qi has to be flowing. And for your Qi energy to be flowing through the meridians across the whole body, you've got to get moving. Okay, I mean, in Qigong, we do simple things like just slapping to wake up the meridians and the energy running through the channels. Okay, shaking techniques, and we do breathing techniques, moving meditation. So these are all the things that I teach in my KAMOTiON Qigong Mastery Commune. If anyone's interested, come and check it out. There's a 1 week free trial. Okay, there's a link tree in my bio. Hit the top link, read all the information on it. There's a class you can watch, a previous class on there. We started it in April, so we do two classes every week. Class on Tuesday and a class on Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern time, 6 p.m. UK time. So class tonight. So if you want to come and check it out, come and check it out, because that's where we do the practice. Okay, obviously learn the actual techniques of practice, because there is a system to this. There is a system. I've actually made spirituality, and really what I'm doing with the KAMOTiON Qigong system is creating a lifestyle which takes people from depression to awakening, okay? Overcoming addictions, depression, and getting out of that shit, okay? Overcoming trauma, overcoming, because the past is what holds people back. The past doesn't even exist. Where is it, man? I can't even see it. Where is it? It only exists in your mind. So you've got to change. So there's NLP techniques that I use, which with clients, and sometimes we do this stuff in the classes as well. So I bring NLP, timeline therapy, Qigong, all of this together to help people transform and keep transforming. And then the classes keep people motivated, because people lose discipline, okay? They find it hard to do the practices themselves. They find it hard to keep themselves motivated. So it's all about accountability. When you have accountability, like me as your coach in the commune, okay, and we're doing the classes every week, I'm keeping you motivated. I'm keeping you inspired. We've got challenges, okay? You take the challenges and you complete the challenges. I can see who's completing the challenges. So we've got like a cold shower challenge. We've got the breathing techniques, lower Dantian and middle Dantian Qigong breathing techniques. So I put new challenges up to keep people motivated and disciplined, because it's the discipline and the motivation that makes the difference. It doesn't matter what you do. Change and growth doesn't happen without discipline. Doesn't matter whether it's physical, mental, spiritual growth. All three require discipline and discipline practice. So you've got to have practical techniques that you can actually do. You've got to know what to do, and then you've got to do it. It's that simple. Okay? I've said it before. Four stages of learning. Unconscious incompetence. You don't know you don't know. Then there's conscious incompetence. You now know you don't know. Okay? Then there's conscious competence. You learn how to do what you're supposed to do. And then unconscious competence is mastery, when you do it without even trying. That's the Wu Wei state, which I take people into in my classes and everything that I teach. So to get from lower consciousness to higher consciousness, you got to learn how to get into this flow state at will, whenever you need to get shit done. So high performance state is what I've taught stock market traders for over 20 years, okay, to perform the best at their game. Sports athletes use this, okay? So it's all about flow state. Like me here, when I come on live, I don't plan, I don't script anything. I just come here and talk. Flow state. Okay? It has to be flow state. Most of the time, you are living life without consciously thinking. Most of the time, it's unconscious flow state. You're just not aware of it. Most of what you're doing every day is unconscious. You're not doing it with conscious effort. You make choices and decisions. I'm going to go here. I'm going to make a cup of tea. I'm going to choose this from the menu. Okay, I'm going to start work. But once you make that choice and you get there, the rest of it is unconscious. So what you need to master is your unconscious mind and your energy, not your conscious thinking. Right? A lot of people don't get that. This is the power of bringing neuro-linguistic programming and psychoanalysis, neuroscience together with Qigong energy work. All right. Good stuff. Paula, good to see you. Yeah, thank you very much. Come and join it. Yeah, check it out. 1 week free trial. It's only £65 a month after that, which is fantastic. And I say to people, it's like a gym, okay? You come there, like you do the class every Tuesday, every Thursday, and consistently over time, you're going to have that compounding effect, just like you go to the gym, okay? You're going to feel it the first time you go. You're going to feel it the second time you go, but every time you keep coming to the classes, and most people will come to the live classes. Some people watch the recordings because I record every session. So if you can't make it live, you can watch a recording. And actually, you get access to the recordings of all the past classes. So since beginning of April, we've got over 20, at least 25 classes there now. Okay, which you can actually go back and watch as well. So there's posts. It's like Instagram, but it's private. So it's only community members in there. You can put your own posts on there when you're doing the challenges. So check it out, you know, really highly recommend at least check out the page where the information about the KAMOTiON Qigong Mastery Commune is. It's the follow the link tree in my bio, top link, and then you can read all about it, okay? Any questions, just drop me a DM or you can email me on info@themindofmatter.com. Yeah, it'd be good to see you. Actually, we've got a class tonight, so if you want to get in. So yes, Gurch, link tree in my bio, top link. Be good to see you guys there. Got a lovely group already there, and people have, they're actually the people that joined at the beginning of April have been there since the beginning. Okay, so none of the members that are actually joined have joined right from the beginning have actually left. They've continued the classes because they're getting so much out of it. So that just speaks for itself. All right. Thank you very much for joining in, everyone. So much love. I'm going to actually do nothing for a period of time now. So that's the Taoist way. Like, do nothing, let go. Like, really, when you let go, like, really let go. Like, you know when I say be at peace? The best way for me to find peace is to witness and observe nature. Why? Because I need to keep reminding myself, I'm nature. I was born without a business plan. I'm going to die without a business plan. My body's staying alive pretty much by itself. I'm not asking for a heartbeat or blood pump. Okay, it's just happening. So I need to trust. I need to trust this divine force that's in control of all of nature, including us. Right? And that's really what it's all about. Just keep connecting with that, reminding yourself there's an effortless fucking flow to all of this. Right? There's an order to the chaos. There's an order to the chaos. Right? You know, when there's a storm and there's a, you know, there's shit flying everywhere, it's just chaos. But you look at the hurricane from above is an orderly swirling thing. Right? So there's an order to everything. As above, so below, as they say, right? As above, so below. There's a direct influence from the sun, the moon, celestial chi. Okay, I teach this in the Qigong commune as well. There's a celestial chi from the sun, the masculine energy, and there's celestial chi from the moon, which is the feminine energy. So that's the yin energy. Okay, the sun comes out during the day. We need to use these energies because now the spring and the summer is actually the yang period for the whole year. So the Taoists have known this for a long time, right? The nature, and everyone knows this really, they're just not aware of it or paying attention to it, but nature itself goes through seasons. Okay, yang and yin seasons, right? So the autumn, fall, winter, everything dies because it's the yin season. Everything comes back alive in spring and summer, and the days are longer because it's the yang season. The sun shines longer. The days are longer. So we have ability to harness more celestial chi during the spring and summer. It's not that you can't harness it during the autumn and winter. You can. It's just that you've got it more on your side here. That's why the plants and the flowers and the trees and everything else is making use of it. That's why the flowers start blossoming, because they make use of the energy when it's there. And human beings, what do? Oh, it's just spring. It's just summer. And here comes autumn and fall, and just waste it every year. Right? Even my cat knows to make use of this energy. Right? My cat is a very different cat in autumn and winter compared to spring and summer. Right? So learn from the animals, learn from nature, man. It's always teaching you. It will teach you more than any book. All right, much love. Thank you very much for joining in. Hope to see you in the classes. Take care. Link tree in the bio, top link. Read all about it. Any questions, just drop me a DM.